Hello everyone, welcome. Myself Prithviraj P. Tambe. I am working as an assistant professor in electronics engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Let us today learn code converters, their design and implementations. At the end of this session, students will be able to examine the working of code converters, design and implement code converters. In digital systems, variety of binary codes are used. Examples are like BCD, Gray, ASCII, etc. So there is a need of code converters, which are often required in many digital processing systems where multiple digital systems communicate together. A multi-input, multi-output logic circuit that converts one code word to another code is you can call as a code converter, where input pattern represents code word in one code and output pattern are corresponding representations in different code. So code converter makes two digital systems compatible even though they uses different binary codes. Let us today learn 4-bit binary to gray code converter. So first step in any design is the requirement and specifications. So let us learn the requirement for this 4-bit binary to gray code converter. So 4-bit binary to gray code converter requires 4 binary inputs B3, B2, B1, B0 and 4 gray outputs G3, G2, G1, G0. Second step is truth table. So we need to derive a truth table which contains total 8 columns because we have 4 inputs and 4 output lines. But before that, we need a table which contains all the code word for binary as well as gray code. So let us calculate total code words possible for 4-bit binary code. So yes, the relation is 2 to the 4, 16 code words are possible. So the derived truth table contains total 16 rows corresponding to each code word. So your complete code table will look like this. So we have decimal 0 to decimal 15, binary 0000 to 111 code words and their corresponding gray codes. Now next step is the simplification. So we need to derive a simplified Boolean expression for each output as a function of input variables with the help of truth table and Karnaugh map. So let us find optimized equation for G3. So as we have 16 code words, we required 4 variable KMap. So after putting all the values of zeros and ones in a code table, from a code table in a KMap, the KMap will look like this. So here we have 8 adjacent mean terms. So when you group them, we will get a octet. So for this group, we have equation B3. Let us go for G2. Again, we required a G2 column. So after putting all the values in KMap, so you'll see here M4, M5, M7 and M6 are the mean terms. M8, M9, M11 and M10 are the mean terms. So we have here 4 mean terms adjacent to each other, And here we have again four mean terms adjacent to each other. So we have here now two groups, G1 and G2. So let us write down the equations for G1. So G1 is nothing but B3 bar B2, and G2 is B3 B2 bar. So your G2 equation will become B3 bar B2 plus B3 B2 bar. For G1, again plus the corresponding mean terms in the K-map. So we have here M3, M2, M11 and M10 adjacent mean terms. And second group M4, M5, M12 and M13 mean terms, which are again adjacent to each other. So let us find this group 1 equation. So for group 1 we have B2 B1 bar, and for group 2 we have B1 B2 bar. So your G1 equation will look like B2 B1 bar plus B2 bar B1. Now for last G0, after placing the mean terms, we will have M1, M5, M9 and M13 mean terms, which are adjacent to each other. M2, M6, M14 and M10 mean terms, which are adjacent to each other. So we have again two groups. So we have here actually two chords. Let us write the equation for G1. So G1 is B1 bar B0 and G2 is B1 B0 bar. So our G0 equation will look like B1 bar B0 plus B1 B0 bar. So after implementation, you required all four equations. So this is the summary from the previous slide. So G3 is equal to B3, G2 is equal to B3 bar B2 plus B3 B2 bar, G1 is B2 B1 bar plus B2 bar B1, and G0 is B1 bar B0 plus B1 B0 bar. So let us implement all these using basic gates. So we required some gates. So NOT and OR, these are the three basic gates. So let us calculate total number of basic gates required for this. So you will see that here for each input we required one NOT gate. So B3 bar, B2 bar, B1 bar, B0 bar. Again we will see here there are 6 AND terms. So 6 AND terms, 4 NOT gates and 3 OR gates. So total number of gates are 13. But still we can require one optimized implementation. So if you look each term carefully, each expression carefully, you will observe that these are XOR expressions. So G2 will be actually B3 XOR with B2, G1 will be B2 XOR with B1, and G0 will be P1 XOR with B0. So our new equations will look like this: B3 XOR B2, B2 XOR B1, B1 XOR B0. Now if you compare these two implementations, you will observe that with the basic gates the circuit requires 13 gates, but with the XOR gates you required only 3 XOR gates. So here you have reduced 10 gates. So your final circuit diagram contains 3 XOR gates connected like shown in the diagram. So G3 is equal to B3. So we require direct one line from input to output. G2 is B3 XOR with B2. So this first XOR gate takes input B3 B2. G1 is B2 XOR with B1, and G0 is B1 XOR with B0. So in any design, implementation is the most important step. because in implementation we required to use minimum number of gates for optimal performance. These are the some references for further reading. Thank you.